Hi, we're here with Mark Hackett of the Bangor High School Rams. Coach Hackett, how did practice go this week?
Practice was super. They seem to be a little bit more focused on what it is they want and what they've done to get here. There wasn't much fooling around this week.
Could you tell me a few keys that you think will be effective tonight versus Brunswick?
Well, we're going to have to stop the fullback first, and if we can control him, then obviously Mims running outside around the end, we'll have to take care of him also. And we feel like we have a pretty good game plan. We'll play 52 defense, and hopefully we'll be able to contain those two guys.
Do you think the cold will be a factor?
I hope it affects them more than it does us, but the cold always affects the game. But it's a game of football, and I think the tougher team wins when it's bad weather.
Okay, well, thank you for your time, and good luck and congratulations on your season.
Thank you very much, guys.
Hello, we're here with Coach Levitt tonight of the Brunswick Dragons. We have a few questions for you, Coach.
Go right ahead.
How was practice this week preparing for Bangor?
Probably the best week of practice we've had all season.
Could you tell us some offensive and defensive keys tonight that you're going to be doing to stop Bangor?
Well, I think for us offensively, we want to control the ball and keep their offense off the field. We'd like to try and keep the Prentice kid from having a lot of big runs. A lot of people have been very successful doing that, but you know, we feel that we're pretty solid on defense. We'll see how it goes.
Okay. Good. Thank you for your time.
Great. Thank you.
Have a great game, Coach.
Good luck, Coach.
Hey, Eastern Maine, are you ready for some high school football?
Good evening and welcome to Page Employment and Seaboard Security's Game of the Week. Tonight, the Bangor Rams host the Brunswick Dragons here at Cameron Stadium in Bangor. Tonight's game is being taped and replayed on WFVX Bangor 22, Cable 10 on Tuesday, November 18th at 10:30 p.m. Tonight's film crew for Page Employment and Seaboard Security are myself, J.J. Jackson, and my associate, Chris Bombardier, camera persons, Eric and Pam Baxter, key grip, Shelley Gray, executive producers, Bill and Jerry Baxter, production facilities, Associated Media Productions, and for a copy of the game, contact Higgins Video at 989-5125. So, Chris, what do you think are going to be some of the keys that both these teams are going to need to hit to push them over the edge towards the state championship next week?
I believe for Bangor it's going to be the offensive line and Mike Prentice. I think it'll come down to discipline. The team without that has the least penalties, I think, will come out on top. For Brunswick, they have a very athletic quarterback as well as fullback. I believe that if Brunswick can get a ground game going and a passing game, then I think they'll be all set.
Both these teams have very explosive offenses with, like you said, Mike Prentice and the offensive line of Bangor, as well as Heber, and they also have Payson in the backfield for them. And as far as Brunswick goes, they have a heck of a fullback in Philip Warren, who has shown to be one of the better running backs in the league this year. Coaching-wise, was there anything that Coach Hackett said that they were going to be doing different that was going to help them out?
I think that just the discipline. I think the tougher football team wins, and that's what Coach Hackett said tonight. He said whoever's tougher will win. They have great leadership in P.J. Dow, Trevor LaGrange, Mike Prentice, and Tyler Heber, the four captains. Tremendous leadership in all four of them.
And as a quarterback, what would you say to Sullivan and Ralph Mims tonight to help them get ready? What would be their keys? What are they going to need to focus on tonight as quarterbacks?
Not make the mistakes. Stay disciplined. Don't throw interceptions. Try not to fumble. Hang on to the ball as much as possible, and just be a leader. You know, a lot of players in that huddle. They need the leadership. They need from the quarterback to stay confident. I think both of them are great leaders.
And I think that's a good point. I mean, a lot of teams don't realize that mistakes that you make yourself are what's going to cost you a game. And it's a big thing when you get here to the championships. These players are out here. You know, they're at the top of their game at the end of the season. And you know, these players are going to break a few games, but they're going to break a few plays. But you need the bend to not break, and that's what both these teams have done to get here. And I think we're in for an extraordinary game.
I think it might come down to one big play. I mean, they're both outstanding football teams. And one big, huge play might decide it between the two.
And it's like you were saying about the offense and defensive line, the offensive line of Bangor has been very good all year long. And you on the offensive line of Bangor, like you said, you have P.J. Dow, who's a captain, who has been an extraordinary player. He played defense his junior year, I believe, but he's been an awesome player on offense and defense for them. That's number four, P.J. Dow. And also, you got Danny Day, Trevor LaGrange, Eric Anderson, Ricky Dexter, Kyle Oliver, and Kevin Flynn. which all of them, you know, have a lot of playing experience, have been playing together for a long time, and I think that that's a good core of veterans that's going to help the Bangor offense, and there's a lot to be said for the Brunswick offensive line as well.
Brunswick offensive line consists of number 38, Garrick Macy, number 72, John Hamilton, number 64, Nathaniel Burnett, number 77, Sean Clement, number 71, Tony Prenick, number 65, Eric Schultzberger. I think it'll be a great match between these two enormous offensive lines.
It should be a great game. You know, a clash of the Titans, you'd almost say, right here. I mean, you couldn't ask for a better end of the season right here with two, you know, quick-scoring teams, two big offensive and defensive lines. It's going to be awesome. So.
Not only that, they're going to have a little Brunswick's going to have a little revenge for the past state game that they lost to Bangor, I think. I think they're going to have a little chip on their shoulder, especially from the quarterback, Ralph Mims. I think he might come out and show Bangor a little something. I think he really wants this game. I think he wants to bring Brunswick to the state championship. And I don't think he'll settle for anything less. I think it's going to be a great game. It's going to come down to the end.
You know, and I think special teams also could be a big factor here tonight. As you know, Bangor has had Heber back on returning kickoffs, and he's returned a few this year, and always dangerous Mike Prentice back there. So it's going to be a big factor. You know, special teams is one of those things that you have to keep track of, and everybody's going to be on their toes. You know, it's a quick play if you play it right, but, you know, it can end up in big points if you don't. Chris, you were a return man. Are there any things that can help you get some extra yards there on the returns? Or?
I just think make sure when you're returning a kickoff or a punt, the first thing is make sure you get a hold of the ball. You never want to fumble. You never want to turn over. It could change the momentum of the game and just change it all together. You don't want to drop the momentum. You want to keep the momentum through the whole game. And the person that has the momentum at the end will win.
Yeah, so like you said, you know, minimize your mistakes, and that'll help you win the game. And that's definitely going to be a battle here tonight. We have, you know, two teams here that have been playing great all season long. Brunswick, who had an amazing defeat last week over Gardner, and Bangor, who defeated Mount Blue last week in two very good games, fought hard down to the end. And here on a bitter cold, windy night in Bangor, we're going to have the Eastern Maine Championship decided. And I think, you know, this is where it should be every year. When it comes fall around this time of the year, it's great to be out here at a football game.
You know, tonight, very, very brisk night, very, very breezy. Do you think that the wind and the cold will have any effect on the players down the field?
Well, as a lineman, you know, I know that a lot of the hits are going to sting a little bit more for the guys, and, you know, maybe some of the bumps and bruises are going to stay with you a little bit longer. But generally, when you're out on the field, all you're thinking about is the other 11 players on the field across from you. So I don't think that the cold so much will affect as much as the wind. We'll see if the wind keeps up, then I think the passing game might be hindered a little bit. We might see a little bit more running.
Well, I know as a quarterback, whenever I would have a rainy night playing football or breezy and cold night, it's very, very hard to throw the football or even hold on to the football. I remember when I played, I used to wear these padded gloves, and it would help me get a grip on the ball. I wonder for Ralph Mims and Sean Sullivan what they're going to do to help them hold on to the ball and throw it.
Well, both of these quarterbacks are very shifty too, and can do things with their 2 feet. So, you know, if they, you know, we might see a little bit of play action with the quarterback rolling out, and if nobody's open, you know, it's getting real windy, we might see, you know, number 7 for either team take off and, you know, gain some yards. You know, wherever they can get it, it's going to help both these teams. So,
Sean Sullivan is very, 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 well, not very small, but he's small for a quarterback, but he does the little things to get it done. He has the biggest heart on the team, I think. You know, he has the motivation to help the other players in the huddle. Even when he's on the sidelines, you can see him jumping up and down, yelling all around, you know. That's what you need. Well, this is going to be a brisk, cold night here at Cameron Stadium in Bangor.
Well, as we get ready for kickoff, we're going to take a break right now from Cameron Stadium. This is Page Employment and Seaboard Securities.
Ladies and gentlemen, both teams had outstanding seasons. Be proud of your team. Please display good sportsmanship tonight. Bangor High School welcomes you to Cameron Stadium for tonight's Pine Tree Final between the Dragons of Brunswick High School and your Rams of Bangor High School. Let's meet the lineup. First, the starting Brunswick defense. Bye.
linebacker, a senior, number 5, Tyler Montgomery. At linebacker, a senior, number 6, Devin Shepherd. At defensive back, a senior, number 7, Ralph Mims. At cornerback, a junior, number 14, Justin Clark. At linebacker, a junior, number 38, Garrett Pace. At tackle, a senior, number 47, Philip Warren. At tackle, a senior, number 64, Nathaniel Burnett. At defensive end, a senior, number 72, John Hamilton. At tackle, a junior, number 79, Aaron Chapin. At defensive end, a junior, number 84, Brandon Krause. And at cornerback, a junior, number 85, Kevin Scully. The assistant coaches are Dan Cooper, Mark Tucker, Larry Berberich, Bill Chupont, Sergio Wooden, Sean Austin, Terry Hart, Peter Tucker, and Chris Wright. Brunswick's head coach is Dick Levitt. Now let's meet the Bangor starting offense. At wingback, a senior, number 2, Tyler Heber. At split end, a junior, number 3, Anthony DeRosa. At tight end, a senior, number 4, P.J. Dow. At quarterback, a senior, number 7, Sean Sullivan. The fullback is a junior, number 20, Aaron Gallant. At tailback, a senior, number 28, Mike Prentice. At guard, a senior, number 51, Trevor LaGrange. A junior, number 53, Eric Anderson. At guard, a junior, number 63, Jeremy Tyler. At tackle, a senior, number 72, Danny Day. And at tackle, a junior, number 76, Kyle Oliver. Bangor's assistant coaches are John Tennant, Mike Misrenner, Jack Kurtzman, and Lance Fenor. Bangor's head coach is Mark Hackett. Tonight's officials are the referee is Mr. Mike DeLuise, the umpires Mr. Mike Clark, line judge Mr. Bob Bean, the head linesman Mr. Scott Heath, and the back judge is Mr. Tim Kenny. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please rise as the Bangor High School Band, under the direction of Mr. Scott Burdett, honors America with the playing of our national anthem. Tonight's colors are being presented by the Bangor High Junior Reserve Officer Training Corps.
Thank you.
evening, and welcome to Cameron Stadium, where the Bangor Rams are playing the Brunswick Dragons in the Eastern Maine Championship game. Well, Chris, what do you think? What do you think so far? Both teams look pretty good in warm-ups, and it looks like we're getting set for an exciting game right here as we get ready for the coin toss.
As well as very pumped up, JJ. They both are very excited. They're jumping around. They're hopping around. You know, both teams are ready to go. They're ready to go to the States.
And for the officiating crew tonight, we have ref Mike DeLose, line judge Bob Bean, umpire Mike Clark, linesman Scott Heath, back judge Tim Kinney, and scorekeeper John Redman. And captains for the Brunswick Dragons are number 6, Devin Shepard, number 47, Philip Warner, number 72, John Hamilton, and number 79, Aaron Caffin.
The Bangor captains are number 4, P.J. Dow, number 51, Trevor LaGrange, number 28, Mike Prentice, and number 2, Tyler Heber. We're going to look for an outstanding game out of all 8 of these players. Great leadership, as well as hard work.
A lot of these guys are key players right here. A lot of their leadership and a lot of their integrity carries into a lot of these other guys right now as they shake hands and get ready for the coin toss. Looks like the coin was just flipped. See if we can get a call. All these players right now. This is when the nerves get the best here right now.
Getting all
pumped up, waiting for the kickoff, and that's when it all goes away right there for you. Like as we said, the Eastern Maine Championship next week, next Saturday, the winner will be playing the winner of the Western Maine Championship down in Portland on Fitzpatrick Stadium.
That's between Deering and Biddeford. Both teams are undefeated.
So we got 4 great teams playing tonight, or I believe the Western Maine teams are playing tomorrow afternoon. So either way, it should be a great game tonight and a great game next week.
Still waiting on the coin toss. Officials are discussing the rules, and there's the toss.
Looks like they're having a little bit of trouble holding on to the coin because of the wind right now. Brunswick will call because they're the visiting team. They'll get to call either heads or tails. Looks like Brunswick won the toss, and that looks like they got to decide first.
Looks like Brunswick's getting the ball. Brunswick will receive.
Brunswick is going to receive. So the Bangor Rams will be kicking first, and the Brunswick Dragons will be receiving.
Eastern Maine Championships just about to be underway here at Cameron Stadium in Bangor. Very excited fans, packed house.
Looks like both teams are getting very pumped up right here. We'll see the kickoff team that's been very good for Bangor all season long and the return team for the Brunswick Dragons has been very explosive.
Bangor taking the field.
And the kicker for Bangor, by the way, is number 45, Ryan Toomey. He does a very good job. We'll see if the wind conditions here tonight are going to affect the kicking game. And also, it being so cold is going to make the ball a little bit stiff. And, when you're kicking a stiff ball like that, it tends not to fly so far. So we'll see if, the receiving team adjusts. And
A lot of these players play a lot of different positions. They both play both ways as well as special teams. Do you think that will have any effect on either team tonight?
I know that cold air getting in your lungs, that can do something to you. Sometimes you got Brian Lever out there that plays linebacker. You have Mike Prentice out there that plays running back as well as D-back. I mean, a lot of these guys, you're right, And
this is such a pumped up game, I don't think it really even matters. I don't think it's even in any of their minds. And we're underway, here we go. Kick off.
And it's going to be fielded by Brunswick at about the 5-yard line. He's bringing it out. Initially hit at the 15.
Tackled by a bunch of Bangor players, Mikey Prentice and P.J. Dowen on the tackle.
Looked like number 43 was also in on the tackle for Bangor, Matt Currier. So the defense is going to take over for Bangor and the offense for Brunswick.
Brunswick takes over on the 16-yard line.
As you said, the keys are going to be whether the offense and the offenses of both these teams can get fired up. They both have very explosive offenses.
Brunswick comes out split left.
Brunswick has Ralph Mims under center, and they have Devin Shepard in the backfield right now. It looks behind quarterback. As they run a rip to the right, they get about 2 yards, and he's taken down by, looks like he was brought down by the linebacker, Brian Lever. Bangor's defense did a great job right there trying to get – what they want to do is try to take over the line of scrimmage. They don't want to give those offensive linemen anything if they're going to try to stop Brunswick's offense.
They got to tackle as a team, no arm tackles or anything. You got to be as a team.
A lot of these guys are very shifty. Like you said, you know, you got to tackle as a team, somebody is going to slip away.
Hand off right side at number five.
We got number five, Tyler Montgomery. Tyler Montgomery on the carry for about 3 yards. That's going to bring up a third down and five. Bangor looks like they're playing a 5-2 tonight.
Both teams are outstanding at stopping the run, but they both have great running backs as well.
Bangor on the 5-2. We got Ralph Mims under center.
Hand off to the fullback, Warren Phillips. Tackled for a 1 yard loss. That'll bring up fourth and about three or four. And it looks like Brunswick bringing on the punt team. Deep for Bangor, Mike Prentice, number 28, and number 22, Tyler Heber.
Both these guys have been very explosive on special teams tonight. Special teams are going to play a big factor. Not only that, the field position game. So we'll see what Bangor can do right here as they come out with a good stand in the on Brunswick's first possession. Brunswick back, kicks the ball off, and it's a little squib kick off to the side.
Bangor runs away from the ball, and Brunswick will down it.
Brunswick's going to down it at their own 39-yard line.
No return on the play. It'll be first and 10 for Bangor. About the 37-yard line.
Here comes out the Rams offense, led by Sean Sullivan and the big Bangor line. We got the Brunswick defense out here as well. Devin Shepard, the fullback, also plays linebacker. We got Garrett Macy at linebacker. Kevin Scully at a cornerback. Bangor up the middle to Mike Prentice. He gets about 3 yards on that carry, and that's going to bring up about a second and seven. You think this is what we're going to see primarily from Bangor tonight?
Yes, I think that Bangor will primarily run the ball with Mike Prentice, keep it on the ground, use their big offensive line as a weapon, I believe.
Yeah, Bangor's always been a primary running team. If they can, they like to keep the ball on the ground and control the clock.
You know as well as I do, Rams love Ritt.
Bangor up the middle, Prentice.
To the right side.
He's got it out to the side. He's got about 10, 15. He's on the 10-yard line. Prentice brought down at about the 10-yard line. That bring up first down. First down, I think 10. I think they might have a chance to get a first down here.
First and 10 on about the 11-yard line. What a great run, JJ, by Mike Prentice. He's so hard to bring down.
That's explosive running right there. Very explosive running. And the great thing he does, he keeps his legs moving, and it gives, you know, the linemen a lot of energy right there when you break runs like
Number
that.
Number three, Anthony Derosa, split left. Hand off to Mike Prentice off the left side. Oh, gang tackled by a bunch of Brunswick players. About a 2 or 3 yard gain on that.
Looked like number 54 was on the tackle for the defense, Alec Hershey. We got Bangor bringing in number nine here. That'll be Flynn.
I think they might go a little tight end here. Power eye formation, try to drill it at Brunswick,
it looks
deep
like
in their own territory.
It also looks like Brunswick's putting, you know, about 7 or 8 guys right up there on the front. I think that if they want to prove a point, they want to stop Prentice right here.
Wing back left goes in motion to the right. Oh, we got a flag on the play.
This is where you see if you can punch it in right here, that'll be a big boost for Bangor right here.
That hurts Bangor right there. False start on Bangor.
It's going to bring up second down and 12. So the ball is going to be on about the
12-yard line.
12-yard line. Bangor's going to have a second down and 12. Brunswick seeing if they can make a stand right here. Bangor comes up to the line in the I formation. Double tight ends. Get the flanker in motion. Bangor hands it up the middle to Mike Prentice. Seeing if he can get the corner. If he gets the corner, he might score. He gets to the 5-yard line.
Mike Prentice down to the 2-yard line. What a great run.
And that's leg drive right there. He had about two or three guys trying to get their hands on him. He just kept his legs moving. When the defenders get their hands on you like that, you want to just keep your legs moving. Get any, even an inch counts in this game right here.
Every inch counts, JJ. You are right.
It's 3rd and 3 right here.
3rd and 3 from about the 3-yard line.
Bangor's going with an offset right. They're going power right. Prentice up the middle.
Touchdown, Bangor.
Touchdown, Bangor. That was a great orchestrated drive right there. They just seem to want to power the ball up the middle, and that it looks like Bangor right there is trying to see if they can get their running game working. And we all know that when Bangor gets their running game working, that leads to, they'll open up the pass game as well.
That bread and butter for Bangor, Mike Prentice, he's just something else.
Bangor will come out to attempt the extra point, and it will be number 14, Jordan Heath, trying to attempt the extra point.
And the snap, it's down, up, and the extra point is
no good. Just seemed to hit the upright right there as Brunswick got in very fast on that play.
7:28 left in the first quarter, and we have a score of 6-0, Bangor over Brunswick.
Here we'll see. Hey, and we're going to take a short break. Here we are back at Bangor Stadium. Or here at Cameron Stadium, rather, with the Brunswick Dragons and Bangor Rams. We got a score of 6-0 after the Bangor Rams just scored. Brunswick back to kick off. I'm back to receive.
Square blind drive kick.
Number 6.
Returned by number 6, Devin Shepard. Oh, bounces off a couple of tackles. Breaks it off the middle. Oh, tackles about the 33-yard line.
That was a great effort right there by Shepard. He bounced off a few tackles, kept his legs moving, and drove to give his team good field position right there. They'll have the ball on it looks about the 33-yard line.
Tackle by number 49.
Look like he was talking about number 4, P.J. Dow, was in there on the tackle as well. Bangor comes back out on defense, see if they can do more of what they did before, as well as Brunswick trying to get their offense going. Brunswick sets up and looks like they
split white, right? Guy in motion to the left.
Number 6, Devin Shepard in motion. Looks like they're going to waggle Mims out. Mims around the corner and he gets about 5 yards. Looks like Mims, or more like 7 yards. It's going to bring down second down in about 3. Bangor right here, going to be trying to stop that man all night long. Ralph Mims is very, very quick.
He is very quick at that. He gets the outside, and I believe that he might be gone if he gets the outside on this defense.
Bangor's still running the 5-2.
Ralph Mims under center. Power formation, hand off to the fullback, number 47. Philip Warren up the middle for about a good 4 or 5 yards. That'll be a first down for Brunswick.
And he was gang tackled there by Bangor. It looked like number 57, Dave Berry, got in on the tackle, as well as number 14, Jordan Heath, was in on the tackle as well.
Two powerhouses going at it. JJ, is nothing better than this.
And that's one of the things that Bangor does very well. They gang tackle so that they don't, they don't lose the ball carrier. And that, that's a great thing for a team to have. And Brunswick looks as though they might be getting something going right here.
Split right for Brunswick. Mims under center.
We got number 6 running around the right side. Shepard, and he's caught by number 51, and that'll be Trevor LaGrange. Trevor LaGrange with the initial hit, and that was...
As well as number 53, Eric Anderson, on the tackle.
That's a very good read for the defensive line right there to get out to the outside so quick and make the initial tackle.
On all those misdirection plays, it's so hard to see where the ball is going. You have to have very good discipline.
Trevor LaGrange is a seasoned veteran out there, so he's pretty good at sniffing out just about anything.
We got split left. Flanker, right, motion.
Runs
oh, waggle, Mims rolls to the right. Trying to find a receiver. Oh, it looks like he's going to run. Mims, for a 4-yard gain, runs out of bounds.
And that'll bring up a 3rd down and 6. Ralph Mims has definitely been known to, if there's nothing downfield, he can get some yards on his own 2 feet. He's a very fast person. As you can attest, you played him on the basketball court, and he just flies around with whatever he's doing.
Yes, he has very, very, very quick speed. He's very athletic. We haven't seen his arm yet tonight. He hasn't decided to throw a pass, but if he decides to run it, you better watch out.
Bangor also a very has a very forceful defense. We'll see what Brunswick's going to come up and try to run on this long third down. It's about third down and seven right here.
Brunswick comes to the line. Fullback, one back in the backfield. Oh, looks like a little confusion going on.
Looks like they're trying to check the spot of the ball right here, I believe. Like I said, Bangor has a very strong defense. They basically like to run the 5-2, the base defense. Everybody stays in their zone and does what they need to do, and they get the job done. And like I said, you know, seasoned veterans like Trevor LaGrange, PJ Dow, you know, you got number 57 Dave Barry in there. They got some good experience last week. You have number 76 Kyle Oliver. All these guys are in there, you know, making great plays and trying to hold Brunswick right here. See if they can get them to punt.
Oh, we're gonna go to a quick timeout right here. Be back in a few seconds.
And here we are back, Brunswick on offense. We got Bangor running the 5-2. I think we'll be seeing a pass here from Brunswick.
Brunswick split right, third and seven. Mims under center. Rolls left. Pass is complete. Oh, incomplete to number 47 of Brunswick.
And that was a good play by number five right there for Bangor.
Pass was to Warren Phillips. Hit him in the hands and just didn't concentrate. Didn't keep his eye on the ball, and it fell right down.
It looks like Brunswick will be back here to punt. Dave Barry is wearing number five tonight. A little bit of confusion there. Dave Barry, one of Bangor's linebackers. So we'll see Prentice, number 28, and number two Heber back to return the punt. Looks like Prentice will return this
fair
one right
catch
here.
By Mike Prentice. Mike Prentice touched the ball, fumble on the play.
Brunswick will take over.
Brunswick recovers the fumble.
Brunswick will take over on Bangor's 28-yard line. We said special teams would be a key here in this game, and thus far it has turned out to be. Brunswick will get a second chance right here, and we'll see if Bangor's defense can answer back.
As well as turnovers, did you? They always hurt you one way or another. If you can always score on a turnover, it's always crucial.
Got Bangor back in the 5-2.
Mims under center.
And there's a flag on the play. Both teams seem to be a little bit antsy here tonight. See if they can't calm down. And both teams are sure hitting hard. It's been a back and forth game here so far.
Right now, I don't think the cold's a factor anymore. I think they've all run around enough to get the jitters out. I don't even think they're even thinking about this cold right now.
And Brunswick coming back up to the line.
Split right. Bangor on a 5-2 defense still.
Up the defensive line here, looking to stop Brunswick. See if they can't get him to turn the ball over.
Philip Bourne up the middle. Gang tackled by Bangor. Gets about 3-4 yards on the play.
It looked like number five, Dave Barry, was in there on initial hit, as well as number 76, Kyle Oliver. And looked like Anderson was in on the tackle as well. Be about a second and 11 from the 29-yard line.
We have about 5 minutes and 22 seconds left to go in the first quarter. 6-0, Bangor over Brunswick. Brunswick comes to the line. With Philip Warren and Devin Shepard in the backfield. Motion to the right by number 20, Justin Phillips. Hand off. Philip Warren up the middle. Gang tackled by Bangor. Nowhere to go. 1 yard on the game.
And that was just great play right there by the defensive line. They sniffed that play out, and it looked like number 72, Danny Day, made the initial tackle, grabbing a hold of the running back's feet right there. And that's a great job right there, you know, get a hold of the running back's feet and let the other guys clean up for the tackle. You know, hold them to as little yards as you can. So bring up a third down and about nine, I believe.
Split right. You got Philip Warren and Devin Shepard still in the backfield.
Bangor in the 5-2.
Little motion. We got a waggle pass. Number 14 rolls out to the right. Looking deep. Oh, decides to run it. Tackle just short of the first down for about a 5-yard gain.
Looks like it's going to be fourth down and about four. We'll see what Brunswick does here. It looks like number 14.
Looks like we have a new quarterback in there for Brunswick.
Yeah, number 14, Justin Clark, has come in for Ralph Mims, and we'll see what he can do out here tonight. Brunswick's got a crucial decision right here as they're on the, you know, the 22-yard line going in, and you know, this play could is very important to them right now. They get the first down, they have a good chance of scoring.
Fourth and about four. Brunswick comes to the line. Phillip Warren alone in the backfield. Hand off to Phillip Warren, straight up the middle. Good hard running by Phillip Warren.
And it looks as though he might have the first down. As the chains move right now, Brunswick has the first down, and that's a big play for them right there, Chris. I think, you know, getting that first down is the first step to them, you know, maybe getting the score out of this drive here.
Very, very big confidence builder. I think that helped them a lot, especially with a substitute at quarterback.
That Phillip Warren, he runs very powerful, north-south runner. He's very good.
Brunswick motion to the left. Hand off to Phillip Warren. Bounced off a couple of tackles, couple of spins, down for about a 3-4 yard gain.
It's like number 76 was in on the tackle for Bangor, Kyle Oliver.
Phillip Warren is just a very, very, very big kid. Very, probably very hard to bring down. Bangor needs to gang tackle in order to bring him down on a consistent basis. It looks very strong.
He's a very galvanized running back. When he gets his motor running, it's going to be hard to stop him here tonight.
Justin Clark under center.
Hand it off to number eight.
Number six, Devin Shepard on the run, gang tackled by Bangor for only a 1 or 2 yard gain.
So that's going to bring up another fourth down and be about fourth down and five. Or excuse me, third down and five.
Brunswick being in Bangor territory this early in the game has to give them a little confidence, just knowing that they can do it. It was on a turnover, but these guys just must get a little bit of confidence, have a little bit of confidence right now. Justin Clark under center. Bangor on a 5-2 defense.
Looks like they give it to the fullback up the middle, and he might get about... Looks like he'll get about 2 or 3 yards, and he's brought down. I think it's going to be a fourth down and short here.
Huge play coming up
for Bangor. This is a big play for both teams. It looks like they're playing good hard-nosed football. The offense and defensive line are smashing together every play, and you know it's really a test between the linebackers and the running backs. It's really been a stalemate here between the offensive and defensive line.
Got to work for every inch that you get.
And we have a timeout by Brunswick, and with that, we're going to take a timeout as well. All right, back at Cameron Stadium, we have the Brunswick Dragons on about the 8-yard line.
Fourth and about two. Justin Clark under center, motion to the left. Oh, Mims is back in the game, and he's running it left side. Oh, looking to pass. Caught.
Caught on the 1 yard line.
Tackled at the 2 yard line.
That's very good concentration by Ralph Mims right there to, you know, pull the ball out when it looks like he's most certainly running and to get that pass off right there. That's a very good job.
That's a pass to number 20, Justin Phillips. Down to about the 2 yard line. Now it's first and goal for Brunswick. Great play by Ralph Mims.
A lot has to be said for this Brunswick offensive line right here. A lot of those guys in here are, you know, blocking their hearts off right now. We got Brunswick, Bangor. It looks like they're gonna have six men on the line of scrimmage, trying to stop that run up the middle. And they give it to number 47.
Phillip Warren on the run.
There's a pile up. We'll see if they see where they spot the ball. Bangor here. This is very important for them right here. You never know. There could be a fumble. You never know. You don't want to get up this close to the end zone. And Bangor does a good job to stop them, you know, at about the 1 yard line right there. These big guys, Trevor LaGrange, and you know, you got Danny Day in there. You have Flynn at one of the defensive ends, and PJ Dow with the other. And these guys can be, you know, fighting their tails off to stop Brunswick from getting in right here.
Mims has re-entered the game at quarterback. He's under center. Hand off number six, Devin Shepard, right side.
Looked like number 28, Prentice, made the tackle right there. He hit him before he could get to the line of scrimmage. That's a very heads-up play right there.
Good defense by Bangor. Wouldn't this be a momentum change if they could stop him right here? It's third and goal for for Brunswick on about the 1 yard line.
Bangor is like a steel curtain right now. Their defensive linemen are fighting with all they got, and that's going to be the end of the first quarter, and with that, we're going to take a break. Here we are back at Cameron Stadium here tonight. As the coaches hurry off the field, looks like we're going to get the second quarter underway.
It's beginning of the second quarter. It's 6-0 Bangor.
Ralph Mims under center. It looks like they're going to give it to number 47, Philip Warner.
And he is stopped just short of the goal line again by Bangor's defense.
And that's
what a tremendous stand,
and that's going to bring up a 4th and 7. And this is a very extraordinary effort right here by the Bangor linemen. You have to give it to all these guys right here. They're not going to give it up easy. They're going to make Brunswick work for it. And so far, they've sniffed out everything that Brunswick's tried to do, and they're stopping it. This is a very good play by Bangor.
People standing here at Cameron Stadium. This is who wants it more, JJ. We got a 4th down and about 3. 4th and goal. Mims under center.
Bangor's going to load the line of scrimmage. Fans getting into it. They give
Mims
it.
Mims right
looks
side.
Like Mims to the right side. It looks like he was stopped short of the goal line.
Short of the goal line.
And that is a very, very big play right there by Bangor's. It'll be Bangor's ball on about the 1 yard line.
Mims gave a fake up the middle, tried to run a sweep to the outside, but they just had the angle on him and drove him out of bounds. Great stop by Bangor.
And that's a good example right there of bending but not breaking. Your defense might bend, but it doesn't break in the end. And you know, they came back right there, and that is extraordinary. You can't say enough about the defensive line right there when you do something like that. And as well as, you know, the secondary coming in there for the cleanup tackles after Bangor pushed the lineman back. Bangor's going to push it up the middle with Prentice, it looks like, and he'll gain about, looks like he'll have about a yard. That's going to bring up a 2nd down right now. We'll see what the coaches for Bangor are going to do right here to try to get the ball moving here on this drive.
Brunswick Dragons need to stop.
Brunswick in very good position, you know, to make something happen right here. It's as you know, Chris, it's hard to, you know, move the ball out of the end zone like this. And Bangor's going to come up in the power eye right. And I'd expect them to, you know, run Prentice here. Prentice gets around the left side and
tackled by number 64, Nathaniel Burnett from Brunswick.
That's
great one-on-one tackle.
That's a very good play right there. And, you know, what Brunswick's thinking right here is that, you know, if they can get a stop, they'll have very good position for their offense. And a lot of these guys on Brunswick are very good players. Just to name off some of the Brunswick players, we have a defensive end, number 72, John Hamilton. We have Philip Warren at tackle, Aaron Chafin at nose guard, at the other tackle, Nathaniel Burnett at defensive end, Brandon Krause at linebacker, Devin Shepard, and we'll have the rest of them here in just a second. So Bangor lines up in the I formation with a flanker off to the right side. And it looks like they're giving him the Prentice around the side, and he's got a little bit of running room as he gets to about the 11-yard line, and this will be close to a 1st down right here.
Tackled by number 5, Tyler Montgomery from Brunswick.
And they give him, and Bangor gets a 1st down, and that's a very big boost for Bangor right there. Now they have a little bit of room to work with, and you know, you might even see a few passes out of Bangor. They haven't passed as of yet, which, you know, might throw the Brunswick defense off. And the rest of the Brunswick defense, we have Garrett Massey at linebacker. We have number 85, Kellen Scully at cornerback. Justin Clark, the other cornerback. Ralph Mims at free safety. And Tyler Montgomery at strong safety.
Bangor comes to the line. Power set. Gives it to Mike Prentice. Up the middle. Breaks a few tackles. Still on his feet. Tackled by number 6, Devin Shepard. For a nice 8-yard gain.
That's a great play after the hit by Mike Prentice right there. You know, usually a lot of guys, you know, the initial hit might stop him a little bit, but he just seems to power through the first hit, and it takes about 2 or 3 hits, you know, to take this guy down.
It's good that Brunswick defense doesn't give up, though. Don't let Mike Prentice get in the open. That's good that Brunswick.
That swarming mentality is helping Brunswick out right now so that Prentice doesn't break that big run. They've had 3 or 4 guys in to tackle him each time. Give it to Prentice to the right, and he's going to get about 1 or 2, and then he's stopped. It's going to be about, looks like it's going to be 3rd down and short, I believe.
Stopped by number 5, Tyler Montgomery. Tyler Montgomery on the stop.
And now this is, looks like the official's going to take a timeout, and they're going to measure it right here on the play. And as they take a timeout to measure, we're going to take a timeout too. We're back here at Cameron Stadium, and we're going to get the measurement right here.
It's going to be close.
And both teams anxious to see what the call is going to be right here. And it
just
looks
short.
Looks like they're about half a yard short of the first down right here. And I don't think it'll be any surprise to anybody to see, you know, Bangor line up in the power line, try to slam through for this, you know, half a yard right here. This is going to be who's tougher football right here.
Who wants it more?
You got the offensive and defensive line. All of these guys are going out for it. You got 22 guys out there, you know, scrapping to go to the state final tomorrow, next week. And we'll see what happens right here on this play.
Looking for Brunswick's defensive line to step up right here with a big stop. Bangor comes out, power eye left.
Aaron Gallant in front of Prentice. They hand it to Gallant. They hand it to the fullback. And it looks like he got about 2 yards on the play, and it looks like it'll be a first down. Look like a lot of guys are going for Prentice there on the play, and the fullback just sort of snuck up the middle for a few yards.
Nice run by Aaron Gallant for the first down.
Aaron Gallant, you know, is also, you know, not known as a great runner, but he's a very powerful, strong runner, and a lot of people don't know that he's very fast, almost as fast as Prentice, I believe.
He's more of a straight-ahead runner than a shifty runner. Mike Prentice on the carry off the middle. Hit hard by number 79, Aaron Chafin. Big hit by the lineman for about a three-yard gain.
As the Brunswick coach informed us earlier, that it looks like the Brunswick team is running a bear defense. That they sort of have like seven men up on the line of scrimmage, it looks like. They're trying to load that line of scrimmage and stop the run game of Bangor. And let's say this is a pretty big line for the Brunswick Dragons. So they tried to run a reverse, and it looks like Heber's brought down for about a loss of three.
By number 47, the tackle, Phillip Warren, with a stop in the backfield for about a 3-4 yard loss.
Looked like he just sniffed that one out right there, Chris.
Yes, he did. He came in clean, made the hit. Tyler Heber tried to get away, but just Phillip would not let it happen. Nice play by Phillip Warren.
Good to see some of these guys get excited here, too, after the play. You have Bangor. They're going to have split outs to both sides in the I formation.
Tight end right.
Brunswick still got seven men on the line of scrimmage. They're rushing the quarterback pretty fast. Prentice out to the right side.
Delay to Mike Prentice for a short gain. It'll bring up a fourth and long.
We'll see the punt team for Bangor right here.
Tackled by number 79, Aaron Chafin, again on the stop.
We'll see if the wind affects this punt right here. We got number 6 back, Devin Shepard, to receive, as well as it looks like number 47 will be back there to receive Phillip Warren.
P.J. Dow with a punch straight up in the air. Punt, the wind had something to do with that. Everybody clears away, and Bangor downs it on their own 37-yard line.
And Justin Clark was one to, Jordan Heath was one to down that ball right there. So Bangor will come out and try to continue its success on defense. And Brunswick can try to get something on right here, as they were very close on their last drive. Within inches of the goal line.
It helps when you're deep in your own territory like this if you have a good defense. And Bangor has a great defense. And they do not worry when they get down in their own territory like this. They stay strong and they have confidence.
Brunswick offense with Phillip Warren behind the quarterback. And he's going to fake the handoff and roll out to the right.
Mims is going to run it.
It looks like he passed Phillip Warren right there for a short gain, but a gain of two.
Penalty flags on the play.
As you see right there, Ralph Mims is very shifty and very quick. He has the speed, you know. He can get ahead of somebody using his speed and slow down a little bit so he can set for his pass.
And you never know really if he's going to run or pass. He could start to run it and pull it and pass it at the last second. I mean, you got to stay disciplined.
You got the captain, Trevor Grange, out there talking to the umpire. Looks like the Bangor defense is going to get a little bit of a break here. It's going to be second down and about 11 here for for Brunswick.
Illegal forward pass on the play. Ralph just seemed to be a little bit beyond the line of scrimmage.
Bangor's still running the 5-2. Got Ralph Minton center. He's going to hit number six, Shepard. Shepard's going to get about, it looks like he's going to have about 8 yards here.
Good 5 yards after the hit. Nice run by Shepard.
Looks like he was brought down by number 53 for Bangor, and that is Eric Anderson. That's a great play right there. That little handoff up the middle, it just seemed like a little hole opened up, and he just, you know, squirted through it and got a, like you said, got a few yards after the hit.
Mikey Prentice lined up on the wide receiver for Brunswick. Bangor in their normal 5-2.
Ralph Mims, he's going to hand off to number six, Shepard, off to the right, and he's going to be swarmed after about a 2 yard gain. Looks like he was tackled by number 20, Aaron Gallant, number 72, Danny Day of Bangor.
It's going to bring up a fourth and very, very short for the Brunswick Dragons. Here in the second quarter with 5:10 left, 6-0 Bangor.
And this has been the story of the game thus far, Chris. You know, a long, strong runs, and then it seems like towards the end of the drive, there's been a lot of fourth downs, and, you know, we've seen him go for it a couple times. You know, Bangor had that measurement. Looks like we're going to have another measurement here. You know, both teams, you know the anxiety when you're waiting to see whether or not you get a first down or whether or not you're going to be trying to hold them on a fourth.
Call is very close. It is
a
first down. First down for Brunswick. First and 10 on Bangor's 26-yard line.
That's very big for Brunswick right there. That gives them a whole new set of downs. Let's see what they can do. They're on the 26-yard line right now. See if they can orchestrate a scoring drive right here. Is Bangor still in the 5-2? Going to see what they can do to stop them.
Brunswick split left. Mims under center.
Looks like Bangor's creeping up a little bit. Oh, they're shifting. They hand it off to number 47, Warren.
Warren left side.
Gets around
breaks
the side.
Breaks it wide.
He's going to get to about the... He's going to get to about...
Touchdown,
the, no, it's
Brunswick.
A touchdown. And that was just great blocking right there. As Bangor tried to shift over to the right, the lineman just didn't let him get over there, and Warren got around the side. He's got very good speed for a guy his size. Very good speed. He got around that side, and they just weren't stopping him. He had a full head of steam and blew it into the end zone. It's a 6-6 game, and Brunswick will come out to attempt the extra point. Looks like number three is going to be out there to attempt the extra point for Brunswick, and that's a Darren Gouther. Sorry if I...
Sorry about the pronunciation. Oh, kicker slips.
Kicker slips, and the kick is no good.
Kick was no good. Kicker just tried to kick it, got bad footing, and just slipped on the play. So
you know, that's all part of the game playing on grass.
6-6, tied ball game here, JJ. What do you expect from Bangor next possession?
I think it's going to be close. And we are back at Cameron Stadium. We have a 6-6 game with 4 minutes and 43 seconds left in the second quarter as Bangor gets set to receive the ball. And it's been a very tight game here so far. And we're going to look to see if Bangor can set up a drive right here. The kick is off. It's a little bit of a squib. And it kicked to number 76 of Bangor, Kyle Oliver. And he does a good job of getting his hands on it and covering up that ball.
It's very good that his teammates surrounded him after he jumped on that ball. You always want to surround your teammates on an onside kick.
And as you know, there can be a big pileup going after that ball. You never know who's going to come up with it.
Exactly. Sullivan goes to the huddle.
Let's see what Brunswick can do here on defense. Both teams have been very evenly matched here thus far. As we said, in a 6-6 game, Bangor comes up with a power eye right and a man split out to the
Anthony
left.
Anthony throws a split left. Sullivan under center. Hand off to Mike Prentice, left side. Slips a few tackles, gained for about 2 yards.
It looks like he's tackled by number 76, Joshua Morin, or number 79,
Aaron Chafin.
He's had a few big tackles here tonight. It looks like he's clogging up the middle a little bit and showing Bangor maybe a little bit of a different look than they thought they were going to get tonight.
Great matchup between these two powerhouses tonight. Close game in all, 6-6.
Bangor's coming to line with a power eye right and the man split out to the left. They're going to hand it to the fullback right here.
Nick Payson on a 1 yard run, gang tackled by a bunch of Brunswick players.
It's going to be about third down and 7.
3:53 left in the half, 6-6 is the score.
And this is where you're running on pure emotion right here before halftime. You know that you're running out of time and you want to get down there and score. And you know, for Brunswick, they want to stop Bangor right here. And like we said a few times, it's who wants them more right here. You know, who can break that big play or who can get that big sack. And we'll see what we can see out of these players right now. I think the offensive defensive line is going to be big keys, as they have been thus far.
Anthony Drosa split right. We got a power eye right in the backfield. Sullivan under center. A waggle. Prentice up the middle.
It looks like he's stopped after a short gain, and it's going to bring up about fourth down and six.
As the punting unit comes on for Bangor.
As we've seen so far, punting the ball hasn't been very easy with this wind. You get it too high in the air, and the wind just sort of wants to blow it back. So we'll see if we'll see where Brunswick gets the ball right here. So they got number six, Shepard, and number 47 back to receive, Philip Warren.
Kick to the right side, out of bounds at about the 26-yard line of Brunswick.
And that's a very good kick under the conditions. Doesn't give him a chance to return it, and he gets it under the wind enough so that he gets down there a ways. That's a very good kick right there by Pete J. Dow, and he's been kicking since his junior year in high school.
As a kicker under these conditions, the wind blowing, it's very hard. If you kick it high in the air, that ball is not going to go anywhere. It was a very nice kick by PJ. He made sure he kicked it on a line and towards the sideline.
Brunswick's coming up the line. See if they can get something going here before halftime. See if maybe they can go up in with a little bit of a lead. Mim seems to be talking to his lineman a little bit of confusion maybe. And he hands off to Philip Warren up the middle, and it looks like he's got about
pounding football. 13-yard gain by Philip Warren.
And that was just pure power right there. He kept his legs moving and lowered his head, and you know that's what you want out of your running backs right there. You want them to just keep their legs moving, keep their head down, and get you some yards. So you got 2 minutes and 41 seconds left in the half, 6-6, and the ball's on the 43-yard line of Brunswick.
Brunswick split right. Mims under center.
5-2 for Bangor.
Hands off to Philip Warren again. He is gang tackled by a bunch of Bangor players. Number 5, Dave Berrien on the tackle.
Look like number 51, Trevor LaGrange, had a hand in that tackle right there as well.
That's what they need to do with Philip Warren, is gang tackle. He's a very physical fullback. He likes that power. He likes to be hit because he likes to give the hits. He needs to be gang tackled and brought down. Bangor needs to work as a team, as defense.
So he's a very physical fullback, and as you said, he's not going to go down easily. I mean, you know, you're going to need two or three guys to bring him down, as well as what they do to Prentice. You know, it takes two or three guys to bring him down.
Philip Warren alone in the backfield. Mims drops back to the left. Looks, starts to run to the left. Looks again, throws to number.
It looks like it was broken up by number 40 of Bangor right there.
No, it was complete to number 38.
Oh, it was complete to number 38. As he makes a good catch right there, I think it might have been deflected.
Caught by number 38, Garrett Macy. What a catch. Great play by Ralph Mims to buy some time.
That's very good. You know, that scramble around the pocket, like you said, it gives the wide receivers a lot of time to get open. And right there, it looked like it was going to be tipped by the Bangor defense, but that's good concentration right there to make that catch.
Timeout by Brunswick, and we will take a timeout as well.
We are back at Cameron Stadium. We have a 6-6 game with 1 minute and 38 seconds left in the half, and the ball on the 44-yard line. Brunswick Ralph Mims runs off to the right sideline. Looks like he'll be running it right here, and he's met by number
28, Mike Prentice.
And Prentice, he's just got that quick closing speed, and it's good to see the two speedsters meeting up right there.
First, it looked like there was going to be a big gain on that play, but Bangor cut him off and drove him out of bounds for about a 3-yard gain.
And this is a crucial drive for both teams. Like I said, with a minute and 30 seconds left in the half, and Brunswick right here on the 42-yard line. I mean, they could score. Bangor could stop him. Either way, I mean, it's going to be big for both teams in determining who goes up at half or whether it stays, 6-6.
We got slot left, twins left, Philip Warren in the backfield. Hand off to Warren, straight up the middle. Breaks the tackle, brought down by two Bangor defenders, Mike Prentice, as well as number 14,
Jordan Heath.
That's a first down. That's a great run. That's an eight-yard run by Philip Warren.
And right there, it looks like Bangor was trying to take their linebacker, number five, Dave Barry to the outside to help out the defensive end maybe. They only had one linebacker set back. Looks like they're going to do it again. They have Dave Barry to the outside. Bangor line shifting a little bit.
Same formation for Brunswick. Mims rolls left. Reverse, coming back.
He's going to be met by number 28, Mike Prentice. That was number 14,
Justin Clark
on the reverse right there.
Little trickery, JJ.
It's going to be second down and about four. That was a good play. Keep Bangor on their toes and make them play honest defense. I think it's what Brunswick's trying to do right here.
Brunswick calls a timeout, and we're going to take a timeout with them.
And here we are back at Cameron Stadium. 44 seconds left in the half, 6-6. Brunswick driving, trying to get a score here before halftime. Looks like Bangor is back to their regular 5-2.
Second and about three for Brunswick. Motion. Mims rolls to the left. Behind Philip Warren is running back, and he is swarmed and tackled by number 20. Aaron Galan on the tackle, the solo tackle. That's a great tackle and a clutch play.
That was a great job by P.J. Dow right there. P.J. seemed to just, you know, chase Mims right into the arms of Galant right there. And, you know, that's good help tackling right there. You sort of corral him and take him down. Do it any way you can. That's going to bring up a third down and seven for Brunswick, a third down and eight for Brunswick.
That's a key play by Ralph Mims to stop the clock, get out of bounds, not have to use another timeout. So it brings up about third and three on the 29 of Bangor, 36.6 seconds to go, Mims under center.
Brunswick has twins right. They're going to hand it up the middle to Philip Warren. And he gains about three, and it's going to be about fourth down and six. And it looks as though Brunswick's going to try to get one more play in here.
Clock running, 16 seconds left to go in the half.
Mangor still running there, 5-2.
Mims rolls to the right, drops back, throws, incomplete pass. Turnover on downs, Mangor will take over with 5.7 seconds left to go in the half. Great stop for Bangor.
So what do you think they'll do right here, Chris, with 5.7 seconds on the clock? Do you think they're going to try to go deep, or you think they'll just try to take it into the locker room 6-6 right here?
I don't think they'll get very fancy at all. I don't think they'll throw a pass. I think they'll go with their bread and butter. I think they'll go to Mike Prentice up the middle and just hope that they'll break one and run the timeout and go in halftime 6-6, unless something crazy happens.
And overall, a very, very well-played half by both teams.
Equal half by both teams. Very, very good.
We have the I formation. They're going to hand it off to
Mike Prentice. Right up the middle.
Up the middle, and he's going to gain about 5 yards, and that should do it for the half. As we have it, 6-6 at halftime, and we're going to take it for a break. We'll be right back. welcome back to Cameron Stadium here this evening as we're going to start the second half of the Bangor-Brunswick football game here, the Eastern Maine Championship. And it's 6-6 right now as we get ready for the second half. Just as a reminder, the ref tonight is Mike DeLose, line judge, Bob Bean, umpire Mike Clark, linesman Scott Heath, back judge Tim Kenny, and scorekeeper John Redman. We also have captains coming out. And for Brunswick, we have number 6, Devin Shepard, number 47, Philip Warren, number 72, John Hamilton, and number 79, Aaron Chafin.
And the captains for Bangor are number 4, P.J. Dow, number 51, Trevor LaGrange, number 28, Mike Prentice, and number 2, Tyler Heber.
And we saw, you know, a very well-played half of football right there. As we said, 6-6 in the first half, and I'd look to see a lot more of the same here in the second half. And, the pressure builds as you get deeper and deeper and closer to the end of that fourth quarter. So the Bangor will receive here to start off the half, and they'll try to see if they can't get something started right here. And both teams pretty much have been primarily running here tonight. Chris, have you been surprised to see that, or surprised there hasn't been more passing?
I'm surprised there hasn't been more passing. Usually you have to pass sometime to open up that running game, but I don't think I've seen Bangor pass one time this game. They're just sticking to the bread and butter, Michael Prentice up the middle, around the ends. That's the way it's been all year for them. For Brunswick, they had a little of both, mostly to their running back, number 47,
Philip Warren. Yeah.
Warren, he had the majority of the carries, as well as Ralph Mims.
Yeah, it looks like both teams are trying to play a little bit of a who's tougher game. Bangor comes out running and scores a touchdown, and Brunswick answers right back on special teams, and both the teams seem like they want to run and prove that their running backs or have what it takes to be in the state championship. And thus far, it's made for a great little half of football for us right now as we get ready to start the second half of football. We have Prentice and
Prentice and Tyler Heber back deep.
Tyler Heber back deep, and we have number 57 kicking for Brunswick. That'll be Derek Paquette. Heber will field it at about the 15. He's got a good head of steam.
Tacking about the 24-yard line.
So that'll be first down and 10 on the 35-yard line.
What do you think they'll do different this half, JJ, to maybe be a little bit more successful?
Well, I think that, both teams' coaches probably a little fired up, trying to get their men rallied up at halftime. And I think we'll probably see a lot of what we saw early in the game. You're not going to want to change much when the game's this close. Maybe you might see a little bit more passing out of Bangor, but, Bangor in the eye, they're going to hand it off to Mike Prentice up the middle.
Gang tackled by bunches of Brunswick players. Number 75 in on the tackle. Andrew Williamson in on the tackle for Brunswick.
Look like number 5, Tyler Montgomery was in there on the play as well.
Short game for Bangor to be a 2nd and 7.
Both teams right here are going to be coming out to look out, coming out to stop the other team. They want to stop the progress and see if they can't get their own trains rolling. Bangor here in the I formation.
Turns, handed to Nick Payson up the middle. Gang tackled all Brunswick players there.
Look like number 6, Devin Shepard, number 72, John Hamilton, and a bunch of others were in there on the tackle. Brunswick doing a great job right now, swarm tackling and stopping anything that Bangor's trying to do on the ground, pretty much. That big defensive line of Brunswick has been doing very great thus far tonight. That's going to bring up a 3rd down and about 9. Brunswick still got 7 men on the line of scrimmage. It looks like it'll be
Sullivan
a pass.
Sullivan draws back, quick pass to Anthony DeRosa, right down the line, stopped. For no gain.
And that'll bring up a 4th down and about 10, and you won't see the punt team for Bangor coming out here.
Great lift for Brunswick to come out and stop Bangor on that first possession. 3 and out for Bangor. Now Bangor is punting 4th and 11. Back deep, Shepard and Warren for Brunswick. Snap, P.J. Dow with the kick. Low line drive, caught by number 47. Fumble on the play, he recovers, runs left.
Looks like he
breaks a couple tackles and out of bounds at the 41-yard line.
Looks like Aaron Gallant in on the tackle right there. And looks like both teams are sort of trying to figuring out each other's process right here so far in the second half. And See if the Bangor defense can keep up its little bit of a steel curtain that it's had so far this game. Bangor's been very tough, and as we said, you know, they bend, but they don't break very often. We'll see if they can keep that up.
For Bangor, you really know what's coming here. They're going to give it to their big fullback up the middle or around the end. He's been their bread and butter even this game. I mean, they got to look for that, and as well, they have to look for Ralph Mims around the end, running or passing.
Yep, Philip Warner has been a big success thus far this game. Bangor still run their 5-2. They hand it off to Philip Warren. He's
up the middle, breaks a couple tackles. Warren for an 11. Oh,
fumble
on the play.
And it looks like it's going to be covered by Brunswick. And that was a good run right there. It's Philip Warren showing that he can be a little bit shifty and gains about 11 yards on the play.
Nice run by Philip Warren.
That's going to be a
five yards after the initial hit. Great run.
That's going to be a first down and 10 on the Bangor 48. And this is going to be a battle of the lines right here. We'll see if the Bangor line can get up there and knock that Brunswick line back a little bit and maybe make a stop right here. They hand off to number 6, Shepard. Shepard around the end. And
tackled by Nick Payson and Trevor LaGrange. Good gang tackling by Bangor.
And he gains two, maybe three on the play, and it'll be about second down and 7, I would say. Both teams right here very fired up. And you know the adrenaline's running high right here, and you just have to try to stay focused if you're the Bangor defense right here, and be focused on stopping the key players for Brunswick. Like you said, number 47, Philip Warren, he's doing a very good job, but not only that, but taking over the line of scrimmage. Start with little things and build up right now.
Mims rolls left. Looking, rolls
pressure,
left.
Pressure on from the line.
P.J. Dow with a sack. Great play by P.J. Dow.
And the Bangor line right there just took over the offensive line of Brunswick, and we had some good pressure right there, which allowed P.J. Dow to show off his speed a little bit right there.
Mims rolled left, just looking, couldn't find anybody, and P.J. Dow in the pursuit eventually dragged him down. Great play by P.J. Dow.
That's a great job right there by Mims, not to fumble the ball when he can't see P.J. coming from the backside right there. 6-6 with 8:19 left in the
Brings
game,
up third and
left
15.
In the third quarter.
Third and 15 for Brunswick. Motion to the right side. Mims under center.
And it looks
Face
like it's
to
a
Warren.
Pass.
Incomplete pass to number 6, Shepard. Great defense by Bangor. That brings up a fourth down and about 15.
And I think we'll see the punt unit again here as both teams' defenses come out fired up right here. It looks like it's going to be a battle of who can score first right here.
Back deep for Bangor is Mike Prentice and Tyler Heber. Back punting for Brunswick is number 57.
Number 57, Spencer Con.
Karen.
Let's see if they can't get a good kick, good punt right here. See if the wind's affecting his kick as well.
Low squib.
Looks like they're going to let it go out of bounds. And it's out at about the 22-yard line. That's a very good punt right there. Doesn't give the fast men from Bangor a chance to return it, but also gets it down the field enough so it doesn't give them great field position either. And this Bangor offense, they're going to try to find a niche right here, Bombardier and the defense. Is there anything you think that Coach Hackett's been saving out of his little bag of tricks so far that he might pull out here?
You know as well as I do that Brunswick pulled out a kind of a trickery reverse in the first half. I think something like that's going to come up for Bangor. I think Coach Hackett will dig into his little bag of tricks, and he'll pull something out here pretty soon. Nick Payson on the run right side for about 2 yards. Tackled by number 79, Aaron Chafin. Aaron Chafin is a big body in the middle. He stuffs that middle. He's made a couple of great plays tonight.
And for a man his side, he has extraordinary speed, and like he's been all over the field tonight, and that's what you need out of your defensive lineman. Clog those holes and make it easier not only for you to make the tackle, but for somebody else to make the tackle as well, because when you free up those linebackers, you'll start stopping that team for no game, and you'll see the punting like we've seen from both teams tonight.
Great defensive game plan by both teams tonight.
Brunswick still playing with 7 men on the line of scrimmage. I formation from Bangor.
2nd and 8. Sullivan drops back and trips and falls for a loss of about 5.
Just look like that's just one of those things right there. You get caught up with your offensive lineman, you know. Nobody's fault right there. But Brunswick has Bangor in good position right here now. It's going to be 3rd down and about 13.
Deep in their own territory.
Looks like this will definitely be a passing down for Bangor. Brunswick right now having good success on defense. Both teams struggling a little bit on offense, but I think that's due to, like we said, both teams' defensive lines are very good and very aggressive, and nobody wants to give up points, it seems like, right here.
Paw pass intercepted by Brunswick.
It's picked off.
Still up. Picked off by number six. Shepherd returns it to the Bangor 11-yard line.
And that is a big play right there.
Huge play by the Brunswick defense.
Brunswick getting very excited about that one right there. Shepherd, one of their key players all game, he just came up big, and it seemed like that ball bounced off the wide receiver's hands, and that was a very good heads-up play by the defensive back right there to get in the position to make that play.
Bangor tried a pop pass to their tight end, and it was tipped, and Shepherd just being in the right position at the right time, and it just fell right into his hands, and he made a great play.
That was a nifty little run back right there as well.
Mims under center, split left.
Defense running the 5-2.
Handoff up the middle to number 47.
47, Phillip Warren.
Phillip Warren up the middle.
He gets to about the 5-yard line, and it's pushed back by the Bangor linebackers. It looked like number 5, Dave Barry, and maybe even number 76, Kyle Oliver, in there trying to push him back. It's a very big for both teams right here. If Brunswick can get in, that'll... With the scoring being as few and far between as it has been, this could be one of the key drives that we're going to look back on.
This is big time for both teams right here, deep in Bangor territory. Mims hands off to number 47, Warren, again up the middle, breaks a couple tackles, touchdown, Brunswick.
And that was just a great job right there by the offensive line, opening up the holes. And if you give that man holes right there, he's going to get you 3 or 4 yards of carry.
Like we said earlier, JJ, turnovers just hurt you. And if the opposite team capitalizes on the other team's turnovers, then...
And Bangor right there, lets up a touchdown, but they'll try to come right back and score again. It's 5 minutes and 45 seconds left in the third quarter, and it's 6-12. As Brunswick goes for the PAT right here.
And it looks like Brunswick will come out and try to go for two. Mims under center.
So Getsy moved by Brunswick right here.
Split right, motion left by number 6, Shepherd. Oh, Mims rolls to the left, looking like he's going to run. Runs left side, in for the two-point conversion.
And Brunswick gets a two-point conversion, so that puts them up 14-12.
14-6,
14-6.
Right now, Bangor just needs to take a deep breath. They need to come together as a team, and they need to answer.
And as both teams go to the sidelines, we'll take a break. Nearman Stadium, we have 5 minutes and 45 seconds left in the third quarter, and it's 14-6 Brunswick. It looks as though the ball fell off the tee right here for Brunswick. Being very windy, I'm not surprised. I'm not surprised to see that right now. How about you, Chris?
It doesn't usually happen very often unless the wind is blowing very hard. And as seeing that, obviously the wind is blowing very, very hard out there, affecting the pass, kickoffs, punts, everything.
And as we said, Brunswick gets set to kick off. Bangor to receive. We got Prentice and Heber back deep. The ball.
Low line drive.
Looks like it's going to go to about the 2-yard line, and Heber's going to pick it up.
Running with it is Heber. Up the right side, makes the first move, and tackled. A little beyond their own 10-yard line.
That's a very good kick right there by the kicker. That's what you want right there. Keep it low and something that'll be a little bit hard for the receivers to handle.
That ball just hopped around, and Tyler had trouble getting hold of the ball, and it gave Brunswick enough time to run down the field and make the tackle.
Yep. Anybody that's received the ball knows that those ones right there, the tough ones that you don't want to get, because you never know which way football is going to bounce. The Brunswick defense comes out. They're looking to stop Bangor and maybe try to hold up this score that they just got right
Bangor
here.
Bangor in the power eye left, split left. Sullivan under center. Hands to Prentice right side. Gang tackled for about a 2-yard gain.
And he was tackled by number 72 on Brunswick, John Hamilton.
As well as number 6, Shepherd.
John Hamilton, also one of the captains for Brunswick, showing a little bit of leadership right there, getting into the mix of things and taking down Prentice.
This Brunswick team is some pumped up right now.
Their defensive line is opening up so many possibilities for their defense right now. They have those 7 men on the line of scrimmage, and they seem to just be trying to answer everything that Bangor has been thrown at them so far.
Sullivan under center, hands it to Nick Payson up the middle for a good 3 yards.
And it's going to be about third down and three.
Tackled by the linebacker, Devin Shepard, and the other linebacker, Garrett Macy.
This is going to be a big play right here for Bangor. If they get the first down, this could be the spark they need to roll on to a score. And with Bangor's been that type of team all year long, too. They only need one big play to get into a game and start rolling to touchdowns. So I definitely wouldn't count either of these teams out at this point, especially with so much time left on the clock.
A lot of this game has been mostly about field position. Bangor's been, you know, back in their own territory, deep in their own territory. Brunswick's done a great job pinning them back.
Handed off to Prentice, and he's stopped in the backfield for about a two-yard loss. So it's going to bring up about fourth down and six.
Brunswick's hopping around right now. They feel it right now. 4:05 left to go in the third quarter. It's 14-6 Brunswick over Bangor.
P.J. Dow back to punt, and we're going to see number 47, Philip Warren, and number 6, Shepard, back to receive the punt. Gets off the punt. It looks like it'll be caught, or they're going to wave it off and just try to get away from the ball. And Bangor will down it at about the 49-yard line. Looked like that was number 11, Brian Hackett, that down that for Bangor. Bangor defense is coming out to looking to stop Brunswick right here.
They need a key stop here, JJ.
Must be a key stop. And you know, anything helps in our defense. You know, create a fumble, anything like that. Well, anything that'll cause a spark. And you know, a three and out right here for Bangor might be what they need to get their offensive line and their running backs firing together and get them a score. Anything.
Get Prentice and the offense back the ball. That's what they need right now. It's first and 10 for Brunswick. Mims hands it off.
Oh, he waggles
out. Incomplete pass.
And that's one of the things that Mims does so well is he does that, you know, that fake handoff, and it gets a lot of people, and that's a key element right there. You know, you get the defensive lineman going one way and you run the other, and opens up the wide receivers and maybe even creates a lane for Mims to run.
He's so fast as well. He buys a lot of time in the pocket, or as well as out of the pocket, just running. You never know if he's going to run or pass, so just got to stay home and do the best that you can.
Defense lines up in the 5-2.
Mims under center, both backs in the backfield. Turns, hands it to Warren up the middle, and he's hit immediately. Gang tackled by Danny Day, Dave Berry, among other Bangor.
Oh, there's a fumble on the play.
Bangor recovers.
And I think it was Dave Berry right there that popped that ball out. Number 5, he came in and just stuck him right at the line of scrimmage.
Dave Berry with the intense hit on Warren, just made the ball pop right out. Bangor jumped on it. Great play for Bangor.
That's the type of thing you like to see. The defensive line held up the running back long enough for Dave Berry to get a good hit on him, and the ball pops out. That's just one of those things that happens in football. Let's see if that'll spark the Bangor offense to maybe get some yards right here as the Brunswick defense comes out and tries to continue their dominance. Bangor has number 8
Sullivan
in motion.
Sullivan on the center. Hands it to Mike Prentice, left side. Getting about 3 yards. Nice run by Mike Prentice. I'm going to take some time now to thank our sponsors, Page Employment, Seaboard Securities, Carpet One of Bangor, Quality Jewelers, Angelo's Pizzeria, Carefree Window and Siding, Bangor Tire, Bangor Optical, Northeastern Log Homes. The patrons are Bangor Canvas, Commercial Screen Print Embroidery, All American Painting, and the Corner Store. Gabby would like to say great job to all the football players.
Here Bangor comes to line. They get a power eye left. I wouldn't be surprised to see Prentice get the ball here again.
Two tight ends. Hands off to Nick Payson up the middle. He's stuffed by a number of Brunswick players for at least a 3-yard loss.
Number 79 for Brunswick. You've been calling his name all night, Aaron Chafin.
As well as number 6, Shepard, on the tackle.
Aaron Chafin, he just seems to be wherever the ball is. And like we said, he's clogging up those holes and making it really tough for the offensive lineman at Bangor.
When you're in those red jerseys, you go to run out the middle and all you see is a big black, big white jersey. You don't know what to do. Brings up a 3rd and 7 for Bangor. Driving on Brunswick's about a 44-yard line. Power eye formation. Sullivan pitches to Mike Prentice right side. Prentice looks for some room, makes a cut, and tackled for about a 4-yard gain.
That's going to make it about 4th down and 3 for Bangor. Be interesting to see what they do right here. Chris, would you be surprised to see them go for this play right here, or do you think they'll try to pin Brunswick down deep in their own territory?
So early in the game, I would look for them to punt. try and pin Brunswick down their own territory, make them drive the whole field if they want to score. And that looks like what they're going to be doing right now.
And as you say that, the punt team comes out. We got number 6, Shepard, and number 47, Warren, back to return the punt.
PJ with down. The punt.
Looks like Shepard's going to let the punt go, and it's going to roll to about the 15-yard line, and it's down by number 11, Brian Hackett.
Great special teams play by Bangor.
As we said, you know, special teams is going to be very key here between two teams. When you're so evenly matched, you never know where a big play is going to come, and a lot of times it comes on those special teams plays right there.
1:31 left in the third quarter. The score, 14-6, Brunswick over Bangor.
To me, first down and 10 for Brunswick on the 15-yard line. Bangor still on the 5-2.
Brunswick comes out, split right, two backs in the backfield. Mims under center, turns, hands it to Shepard, right side. Makes a cut. Tackled by a number of Bangor players, as Mike Prentice as well as Dave Berrien on the tackle.
Seemed like he got through the line of scrimmage right there, and there was just a little pocket of yardage. He picked that up and was tackled pretty quickly after that, but that's a nice run, you know. Just put your head down and go, and that's what these Brunswick running backs have been doing so well tonight.
They get every inch possible, and that's what you need to do in this game. Every inch counts. Brunswick comes to the line. Mims under center, looks right, looks left. Got split left, two backs in the backfield. Shepard. Mims looks like he's going to fall, hands it off to Shepard, and he's tackled by a number of Bangor players.
Looks like Nick Payson was the initial hit on had the initial hit right there. He first sophomore, he flies right around the field. I mean, the way that he plays, you'd think that he was a senior and he's been playing for 3 years. He seems to know everything he needs to know, and you know, every time there's a tackle, it seems we're saying his name. I think he's going to be one of the bright and shining stars a couple years down the road here for Bangor.
Good look to their future. Mims comes to the line, looking right, looking left.
Brunswick has twins out to the right, and they pass it to number 47, Warren. He gains about 2, and it's going to be a 4th down and 1.
It's going to be close here, JJ.
And there's going to be a timeout Brunswick, and with that, we're going to take a short break. Here we are back at Cameron Stadium with the score 14-6 with 7 seconds left in the third quarter. We'll see, and it looks like Brunswick's going to be punting here, and we have Prentice back deep to return the punt. It looked like the coaches just wanted to have a little bit of a talk to Brunswick. Oh, looks like we might have something a little bit different here from Brunswick as they split out all their linemen to the sides, and nothing but the snapper out in the middle of the field.
Such a weird formation for Brunswick, splitting all the linemen right and left. I think that they were trying to draw Bangor offsides, and it didn't work. Good discipline by Bangor. Great discipline.
That's something that I wouldn't doubt that Bangor worked on, you know, during practice at some point. And Brunswick, you know, just making sure that they were on top of their game, trying to see if they could, you know, maybe get a free first down.
The snap, the punt, low line drive.
And that's going to bounce down to about the Bangor 30, and they're going to let it go.
That's a great punt. That's about a 60-yard punt with the roll. Pins Bangor back in their own...
on their own 28-yard line.
28-yard line.
So not bad position for Bangor, but considering where Brunswick was punting that from, that's a very good punt by Brunswick.
It's great special teams by Brunswick and the coverage as well. And that's the end of the third quarter.
And with that, we're going to take another break. Welcome back to Cameron Stadium as we begin the fourth quarter of play between Bangor and Brunswick here in this championship game. Bangor looking to take over on offense, see if they can't get something going and answer back that score that Brunswick had early in the third quarter. Bangor comes out in the I formation.
Patrick Mike Prentice around the left side, trying to get some room over there, and he is tackled. Good tackle out of bounds.
That'll be about a 3-yard gain on the play, so it'll be about 2nd down and 7.
Great tackle by the cornerback for Brunswick, number 85, Kevin Scully.
You know, and Brunswick is doing a very good job containing Mike Prentice tonight. Probably the best job that Bangor's seen all year long, and Prentice being the explosive back that he is, I mean, he's I'd still be worried that, you know, that he might break one of these right here. I mean, both teams have very explosive players, and it's far from over here with over 11 and a half minutes left in this game.
Bangor comes out, two tights. Flanker in motion to the right.
Bangor hands off to
Mike Prentice. And he is tackled for no gain.
He's tackled. He's brought down quickly by Shepard, also one of the captains from Brunswick. Captain showing out in a true fashion here for Brunswick tonight.
Shepard is really showing up tonight, not only running the ball, but defense as well.
You know, it's important for all the players to do well if your team's going to succeed, Chris. But don't you think it's especially important that the captains have a good game so that they can, you know what I mean, set an example for the other players? Or
exactly. Other people look up to the captains for motivation, for help whenever they have a question or something. And that's just, to see that out of a captain is just amazing. It helps a lot of other players around and makes the team better as well.
Brunswick has seven men on the line of scrimmage.
Sullivan rolls right. Pat draws back. Passes. Has P.J. Dow open. And it's caught by P.J. Dow. Running down the field. The 30. The 25. The 20. And he is tackled at the 11-yard line. Great pass by Sullivan to P.J. Dow.
And it looked like Bangor just had Brunswick biting on the run there the whole time. And P.J. Dow sort of snuck out there down the sidelines. Caught that pass, and that was an excellent run after the pass right there.
It was like they were setting it up all night, JJ. Run, 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 run. Surprise for the pass. Like PJ was wide open.
Like you said, you never know what Coach Hackett has in his little bag of tricks, and just like that, it's a 6-14 game, but that makes it a lot closer right there as Bangor is on the
first and 10 on the 11-yard line. Flags on the
flag
play.
Flag on the play, and that'll stop play here for a minute. And that'll get both teams fired up right there. When you have a big play, you know, like we said, you have to have the bend but don't break mentality, and that's what Brunswick's looking for right here.
Especially when you know you're down, you might have a little bit of a, you might second guess yourself sometimes, and that just might help your confidence.
Yeah.
A big play like that.
That's what you need to do. Just keep focused. Don't worry about it. It's one play, and you know, stick in there. And as for Bangor, you just want to use that as a stepping stone to get on a roll.
Exactly.
It's gonna be first down and 15 here for Bangor. Gonna see what they come out with. As you know, they surprised us on that last play. I wouldn't be surprised to see a few more surprises here to get into the end zone.
Come out two tights, power eye for Bangor. Sullivan under center. Gives to Mike Apprentice on the right side.
Looked like he gained about 4 or 5 yards there on that run. That was a nice run right there by Apprentice.
Tackle by number 38, Garrett Massey.
I'm telling you, both teams are doing a great job here on both sides of the ball. You couldn't ask for a better game right now. Both teams fighting hard. I mean, Bangor fighting to score right here. Brunswick up a touchdown. I mean, this is just, when you play football, these are the type of games you want to be in right here.
Sullivan under center, power eye right for Bangor. Two tights. Oh. Hand off from Mikey Prentice left side for about 3 yards.
It's going to be about a third down and 6 here for Bangor.
Defenses have been great in the red zone tonight, stopping the opponent's offense.
And Chris, I definitely say this is four down territory right here in the fourth quarter, and you're inside the 10-yard line. Bangor still has two plays right here. If they don't get in on this play, you know, I'd think they'd definitely be going for it on fourth.
That's all or nothing right here, JJ.
8 minutes and 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter. 6-14, Brunswick lead.
Third down and 6. Bangor comes to the line, power eye right. Turn, handoff to Nick Payson, up the middle.
And it looks like he was stopped at about the 1 yard
line.
Just
short of the first down, I believe. Tackled by Shepard.
And this is going to be a who's tougher play right here.
Fourth down, about one.
I think Bangor is going to try to, you know, drive it up the middle, and Brunswick going to do what they've been doing all night long, loading up that line with their big men and trying to. And it's going to be a timeout for Bangor, and with that, we're going to take a short break. Welcome back to Cameron Stadium here with 8 minutes and 13 seconds left in the fourth quarter. It's 6-14, Brunswick.
This is going to be a clutch play for both offenses and defensive line right here. It's going to be who wants it more between Bangor and Brunswick right here. It's going to be both offensive versus defensive line right here. Who wants it more?
As the crowd gets into it right here.
Go big or go home. Here we go. Fourth down, about one on the 1 yard line. Power. Sullivan under snap. Hands it to Mike Prentice left side. And the call is?
And we're waiting for a call from the officials. And it appears the Bangor will have a first down.
They will have a first down, the 1 yard line.
First down on the 1 yard line. This is very big for Bangor here as they get four brand new plays.
Bangor's linemen, P.J. Dow, Danny Day, Trevor LaGrange, Eric Anderson, Ricky Dexter, Kyle Oliver, and Kevin Flynn really, really wanted it on that play.
And there, you know, those guys are going to have to play tough, you know, these next four plays if they want to get it in there too. Because as you saw earlier in the game, Bangor stopped Brunswick on the 1 yard line, and Brunswick's perfectly capable of doing the same.
Bangor's line comes set. Sullivan under center, turns, hands it to Prentice, and he is hit immediately and dropped by a number of Brunswick players.
That was a great job by the defensive line of Brunswick to get through that line right there and hit Prentice early. If you let him get ahead of steam on the 1 yard line, he's going to make it in there.
Brunswick defense isn't giving Bangor very much to work with here. As soon as the Bangor running backs touch the ball, they are immediately hit by the Brunswick defensive line.
So it looks about second and two, and that big Brunswick defensive line. We have John Hamilton at defensive end, Philip Warren at tackle, nose guard Aaron Chafin, Nathaniel Burnett at tackle, and Brandon Course at defensive end.
Sullivan turns, hands off to Prentice again up the middle, and he is stuffed. That defensive line of Brunswick is just a wall. They are doing a great job containing Mike Prentice.
And Brunswick here seems to be mimicking the play of Bangor earlier in the first half when they stopped Brunswick when they were going in to score. And this has been a game of great defense right here.
Who's tougher? It's third down and two right here on the 2 yard line. Bangor needs a score.
And you know both teams want this deep down in their gut. They're ready to play right now.
It's Bangor down by eight, coming to the line. Sullivan under center. Bangor comes set. Turns, hands it off to Mikey Prentice left side.
And we're waiting
for call yet.
Waiting for official call. It looks like they stopped him on about the half-yard line. It's going to be fourth down
and goal.
Fourth down and goal on about the half-yard line. This could very well determine the game right here. Bangor needs to score. And Brunswick looking to stop him.
It's that big offensive line against that big defensive line. Who wants it more? Brunswick up 14-6.
Bangor has a saying, Rams run rip, and I think that's exactly what they'll try to do right here.
We have a timeout by Brunswick, and with Brunswick, we will take a break as well.
Welcome back to Cameron Stadium here.
Do or die right here, fourth and one from the one, hand off to Mikey Prentice. Up the middle, touchdown, Bangor. Mike Prentice from 1 yard out, right side, touchdown.
That's a big play right there for Bangor. That puts them only 2 points down, and I'm assuming the Bangor is going to go for two right here to try to tie it up at 14.
What a game, JJ. Outstanding play by both teams.
And that right there, that's all the line. When you need a half a yard and it's down in the nitty-gritty and you know the defense is coming after it like that, it's all about the push of the line and the drive of the running back, and it's all legs right there. You work on that day in and day out in practice.
Here goes. Bangor going for 2 points. Sullivan under center. Power eye, hands off to option, and it's a fumble. It's no good on the two-point conversion. There was a miscommunication or a fumble by the quarterback, and Mike Prentice, the running back, jumped on the ball.
That's all right. With 5 minutes and 47 seconds, there's plenty of time left on the clock.
Brunswick leads 14-12.
And waiting for them to come out to receive the kick, we're going to take a short break. Welcome back to Cameron Stadium as we get ready to watch Bangor kick off to Brunswick right now. We have a 12-14 game with 5 minutes and 47 seconds left on the clock. And this game's up in the air right now. The way both teams' defenses are playing, it's anybody's game. Number 14, Jordan Heath, gets ready to kick off. Looks like Bangor's going to try for the onside kick. And it looks like there's a pile up right now. Let's see who comes up with the ball. Referee's peeling the men off the pile.
Peeling the men away. And it looks like it's going to be Brunswick ball.
Brunswick ball on about the 45-yard line. So it'll be first down and 10 on the 45.
Do you think that was a good play, JJ, on Coach Hackett's part to do that onside kick?
I think it took everybody by surprise. And if you take somebody by surprise on an onside kick, that's pretty much the premise of it. You know, catch them off sides, maybe get it. And it looked like Bangor might even got a hand on that ball right there. So I think that was a very good play. You got to do what you got to do to win. This is the playoffs, and you don't hold anything back.
Go big or go home, right, JJ?
That's right.
That's right. Brunswick comes to the line. Oh, the referees are in a huddle right now, discussing something. Waiting on a call.
Both teams going to be looking to go after right here.
Bangor needs a big stop.
And I wouldn't be surprised. Brunswick's going to try to, you know, keep the ball on the ground and keep the clock moving. But they need to get some first downs if they're going to. They're going to need to get some first downs if they're going to run too much time off the clock. And Bangor's been stopping them pretty much three and out a lot of these series, as the defenses for both these teams has been the story so far. The referee is still in there discussing the play, and they signal it's a first down Brunswick. So it's first down and 10 from the 44-yard line. Bangor sitting down there discussing it before Brunswick gets to the line of scrimmage. It's going to be a 5-2 for Bangor. And
Mims slowly walks to the line under center, looks right, looks left. Two backs in the backfield. We got Shepard and
Warren.
Warren, hand off to Shepard, right side with the lead blocker. Makes a cut, and he is tackled.
Tackled after about a 7-yard gain. That was a tough run right there. He had about three men on his back.
Kevin Flynn on
down.
The tackle, as well as number 53, Eric Anderson.
That'll be second down and about three on the play.
Bangor needs a big stop here. Defense needs to step up. Brunswick just looking to run as much time off the clock as possible. Split left for Brunswick.
Bangor maybe looking for one of those turnovers that they got earlier. Bangor's been tough on defense all night long, and I wouldn't be surprised to see a big play right here.
Hand off to Warren straight up the middle. Bounces off a couple of tacklers. Keep on running, pushing. For more and more yards, Warren is finally taken down by a number of Bangor players after gaining about 8 yards.
Boy, is he powerful. I'm telling you, he just keeps his legs moving. And a lot of those Bangor players are getting on him, and you just got to sort of ride him to the ground with guys like that. Take him down, you know, below, you know, right about the belt buckle. And they're doing a good job at getting him down, but when he gets a full head of steam, boy, is he powerful. Got Bangor out there. They're going to try to get themselves pumped up right here for this upcoming series.
Brunswick comes out in a kind of a power formation. Two wing backs, one full back, two tight ends. Wing back in motion right. Turns. Waggle by Mims. Runs to the left. Sees an opening, and he's off around the left end. He's tackled by number...
That was number 20, Aaron Gallant right there.
Aaron Gallant on the solo
tackle. That was a nice play for him to cut off the running lane. It looked like there might be a lane right there, but Aaron Gallant, as we said, has pretty good speed right there, and on the outside, he just cut him off.
7 yards on the play for Ralph Mims. Brings up a second and three. Deep in Bangor territory. About the 35. Brunswick comes to the line. Split left.
Like we said, but it looks like Brunswick's going to keep it on the ground and just try to get first down and run some time off the clock. So
straight
hand
up
it to
the middle
Warren,
to Warren.
And that's
he
a
doesn't
good
know where to go, and he is just stuffed by Bangor.
Hit by Flynn, and that was a great job by the defensive line right there. They pushed the offensive line right back into the running back, and he had nowhere to go.
3:35 and counting.
Right there, that was a great job on Flynn, too. He didn't over-pursue on the play, and, you know, when Warren went to go back the other way, he was standing right there waiting for him. That's a great job by a seasoned veteran right there.
Brunswick comes out, split right. Mims walks slowly up to the line, trying to take as much time off the clock as possible. We have a third down and about three. Big play for Bangor.
Bangor looking for a big stop right here.
Mims turns, hands it to Warren, straight up the middle. And he's tackled immediately for about a 2 or 3 yard gain. It's going to be close, JJ.
It's going to be close.
Real close.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the officials. It's going to be a first down right here.
It's going to bring up a fourth down and short.
Fourth down and short. And this is big right here for both teams. Bangor playing very well right now. It seems like their defensive linemen are stepping up and pushing those offensive linemen back.
It's line on line here, JJ.
And you can hear the crowd getting into it.
Crowd's going nuts right now. Mims under center. Turns, hands it to Warren.
drives ahead, still going for about a 5-6 yard gain, and it's going to be a first down, Brunswick.
That right there just seemed like he found a little bit of a seam and went with it. Not much you can do about it when you find a hole and just get up in there, but Bangor did a real good job bringing him down after not too much right there.
He just turned, lowered his shoulder, and ran as hard as he could. First and 10 on the 26-yard line, 2:16 remaining in the game, 14-12, Brunswick over Bangor here at Cameron Stadium. What a game.
This is the type of game this is worth more than money right here to watch a game like this.
Mims under center.
Bangor still on the 5-2, looking to make something happen right here. Oh, and the play will be whistled dead. There's a flag on the play.
This would be big for Bangor. Delay of game on Bangor, on Brunswick.
Looks like it's going to be a first down and 15.
From the 31-yard line, 1:54 remaining.
Still plenty of time for Bangor to stop Brunswick right here. And, you know, all they need is a field goal to win the game. So if Bangor stops them right here, this will be a great chance for their offense to show them what they can do.
Brunswick comes to the line. Split left, two running backs in the backfield. Mims under center. Turns, hands it off to Warren, left side. Dragging people along, gang tackled.
And he gains about 5 yards on the play. It's going to be about second and 5. Second and 10.
We have a timeout taken by Bangor, and along with that, we will take a timeout as well.
Welcome back to Cameron Stadium. We got a minute and 41 seconds left in the game between Bangor and Brunswick right here. It's a 12-14 game in Brunswick's favor right now. And Bangor looking to make a big play to stop Brunswick and take over the ball and get something going right here.
Both teams know what's going to come. It's Brunswick to Warren. I mean, they've got to run as much time. Oh, Mims right side. Shifts right. Oh, and he hits solo tackle. Great play by Bangor's.
Number Mike Prentice.
28, Mike Prentice. Not only is he a good running back on offense, he's a great defensive back on defense.
And that was a great play by Prentice right there. He wasn't fooled for a minute and just, you know, sniffed that play out and cut back there and got him. That's a big play right there for Bangor because that sets up a long third down and puts Bangor in good position to maybe get the ball back. And that's a great play right there. That's what you need. And with Bangor taking a timeout, we will take a timeout also. Back to Cameron Stadium, and here we have Brunswick trying to get a first down here late in the fourth quarter, and
third
Bangor
and
trying to stop him.
Mims under center, motion left. Hand off straight off the middle to Warren, and he gets about 6-7 yards.
Looks like the tackle made by Dave Berry and Mike Prentice right there. We got a minute and 20 seconds left on the clock with Brunswick up by the score of 14-12 here late in the fourth quarter.
If Brunswick gets a first down here, then I don't think Bangor has enough timeouts to stop the clock as many times as they need.
It's a long, long fourth down here. Fourth down and 7.
Bangor needs a big stop here if they want to have hopes of scoring. 55 seconds remaining in the game. Mims comes under center.
But the defensive linemen are ready to go right now.
Turns, handed to fake to Warren. Mims fakes, run left, and he's tackled! Tackled by number 28, Mike Prentice. And that's a turnover on downs. Bangor will get the ball back with 43.9 seconds remaining. What a stop for Bangor. Right when you thought Mims was going to run with it and get free, he gets shoelace tackled by Mike Prentice. Great job.
That was a great job by Prentice to not only play his position but get around the offensive line and make a great play on Mims right there. And Mims being the fast player he is, Prentice had to show some speed to catch up to him.
Bangor get it back, first and 10 on their own 23-yard line with 43.9 seconds to go. They need something great to happen here.
Bangor been known to get the big plays when they need them, and we'll see what they get right here with 43.9 seconds left. It's a first down and 10 on the
Matt Cassidy split right
yard line.
Sullivan draws back.
Pass to
PJ
Dow.
And he smartly gets out of bounds with a first down at the 41-yard line.
That'll be a first down, move the chains, and that is a smart move right there by PJ Dow to get out of bounds. It's a very heads-up play, and that's something sometimes you can't even coach right there. You have to know the down and situation right there.
Right now, number 7, Sean Sullivan, just needs to be calm and collective, look in his teammates' eyes and say we're all right.
And that was a great job by Sullivan right there to stay cool, calm, and collected.
Bangor comes in line. Mike Prentice split out left. Matt Cassidy split out right. Oh.
We got a timeout by Brunswick, and with that, we'll take a timeout. Going to read off some of the players we got here for Bangor, some of the guys that have been making stuff happen here tonight. We have Sean Sullivan at quarterback, Anthony DeRosa at split end. Halfback, we have Tyler Heber, and tailback, Mike Prentice. Nick Payson playing some fullback, and some of the guys making it happen up front. We have P.J. Dow at tight end, Danny Day at tackle. We have guard Trevor LaGrange, center Eric Anderson, rookie Dexter at guard, tackle Kyle Oliver, and tight end Kevin Flynn. And here we go as they lace it up.
Sullivan draws back, short pass.
Passes to Prentice.
Hurry up.
Looks like he caught it for about a 2-yard gain. Bengals going to try to hurry up, maybe stop the clock right here, run another play.
Sullivan draws back, looks long for Mike Prentice. Oh, Mike dives and just out of the reach of Mike Prentice.
That was a great effort right there. You love to see a guy dive after a ball if it's a little bit out in front of him. There's nothing like seeing these guys go after it 110% right there.
Third down and 7 with 17.7 left in the game. The score, Brunswick 14, Bangor 12. Sullivan goes in the huddle talking to his players. Brunswick waiting on defense.
As we know, Prentice has that blazing speed on the outside. See if he can't maybe bust past somebody and make something happen.
Sullivan drops back, looks over. Incomplete pass to Kevin Flynn.
Leaves 13.4 seconds left on the clock here for Bangor. That's going to bring up a fourth down and about 7.
It's do or die here for Bangor.
Just going to stay cool, calm, and collected right here for the offense. Trying to get enough for the first down, maybe get out of bounds and get close enough for another pass. All they need is a field goal right here to win this game.
They need to break something big here.
And Brunswick's just going to play it safe. They'll probably have their D-backs back deep, not trying to let any big passes go. And
Mike Prentice split right. They should do a quick pass to Prentice here.
It looks like Bangor completed the pass on about the...
Looks like they came up short. Turnover on downs, first and 10. Brunswick going the other way with 8 seconds remaining in the game.
Doesn't look like they'll get the first down here on the play, and looks like the officials want a measurement right here. Both these teams played their heart out tonight, and a well-fought game as 14-12, and a lot has to be said for both these teams right here. Bangor and Brunswick both had great seasons so far.
First down, Brunswick. It's a great effort by both teams. 8 seconds remaining in the game. 14, Brunswick. 12, Bangor 12.
Nobody has anything to be ashamed of on either of these teams.
It's a great fought football team, JJ. Football game. Two tremendous offenses and two tremendous defenses. Just battling to the very end.
I think we'll probably see Brunswick take a knee right here and walk off the field graciously. And Bangor being the good sports they are. And all you can say is, congratulations to Brunswick. And it was a great season for Bangor. And for you guys, for the guys that are juniors, come back and have a great game next year.
Brunswick will face the winner of Deering and Biddeford next week at Fitzpatrick Stadium.
And for our Page Employment and Seaboard Security Game of the Week, I'm JJ Jackson and Chris Bombardier, and we're going to say goodnight.
Ladies and gentlemen, if Brunswick will come over and get prepared to get their plaque, we can get the award ceremony rolling. Gentlemen, we will now present the championship plaques. First, if you direct your attention to midfield, where Mr. Steve Vanestine, the athletic administrator for Bangor High School, will now present
the plaques. First, the Bangor High School Pine Tree Conference runners-up, as well as the plaque emblematic of Eastern Maine Class A runners-up, Bangor High School Rams. Congratulations, Rams. Outstanding season, lots to be proud of. Great effort here tonight. Congratulations. And if someone from Brunswick would like to walk out, we can present the plaque to them. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Stephen S. Nine, Athletic Administrator, Bangor High School, will now present 2003 Class A Pine Tree Conference Championship plaque to the Brunswick Dragons, as well as Class A 2003 Eastern Maine Champions. Congratulations, Brunswick Dragons. Outstanding season, outstanding year. We have a lot to be proud of. Good luck next weekend. Bring back the trophy to Eastern Maine. Thank you very much, both teams. Outstanding job tonight. Congratulations. Thank you very much.
Coach Hackett here at Cameron Stadium. Coach Hackett, is there anything you'd like to say about your team or about the game?
Well, I wish we would have got those 2 points, or actually three, but we played our hearts out. That's a good football team. We never quit. We had a great goal line stand. We got a couple of scores. We thought we needed three to win the game, and obviously we did, and they just outplayed us a little bit. They're a little quicker and maybe more physical up front than we were able to handle, and we just never got any big breaks. Yeah. But I'm proud of our kids, and we wanted to go into the state game. We hoped to win that one, but there were four teams left. We were one of them. We came up a little short, and we wish Brunswick luck.
Well, congratulations on the great season, and good luck to all your underclassmen the next year.
Thank you, JJ. Yeah. Thank you very much.
You have a good one. To the Brunswick Dragons, after they just defeated the Bangor Rams, is there anything you'd like to say about how you guys played tonight, about your players? Or?
Well, I thought we played great. Obviously, Bangor is one of the elite programs in the state, and you know, to travel up here and play at Cameron and come out with a W was pretty special.
Okay. Well, congratulations on a W, and
great.
Good luck in the state championship.
Thank you. Appreciate it.